Hello again with another example related to capacitors combination. I have here four capacitors and I need to calculate or find the potential difference across each capacitor. All right. Now, as I can see, I have a capacitor 1 and capacitor 2 connected in parallel with the battery, which means I can tell straight away that the voltage across capacitor 1 will be 36 volt. And the capacitor 2 also will be 36 volt. However, the combination or the equivalent of C3 and 4 will have also 36 volt. But how they will share that 36 volt, it depends on the charges and the capacitance. We need to calculate that. So let's work it out as a step by step. C capacitor 3 with capacitor number 4, they are in series. They will give me my C equivalent, and to do the math, that will give us 6 microfarad. Okay, great. So my circuit now look like this. I have capacitor 1, capacitor 2, and the equivalent, all connected with the 36 volt battery. So C1, C2, this is the C equivalent. Alright, now once again they are connected in parallel, which means the voltage across capacitor 1 will be 36 volt. The voltage across capacitor number 2 also will be 36 volt, and the voltage or the potential difference across C equivalent will be also 36 volt. Now, I need to know how the capacitor 3 and 4 will be sharing that 36 volt. Now, so that's capacitor equivalent. Moving backward, it's a combination of C3, as we said, and 4. They are connected in series. We mentioned that in our previous videos. I need to bring with me the charge of their equivalent. So let's calculate how much is the charge on this equivalent capacitor, which is the C equivalent multiplied by the voltage on that equivalent. So here we go. It's a 6 micro multiplied by 36. Will give me 216 microcoulomb. Great. So I know how much is the charge now on each of capacitor 3 and capacitor 4. All right. So from here, Q on capacitor 3 must equal Q on capacitor 4, which is 216 microcoulomb. Let's work out how much is the voltage across capacitor 3. Simply, you're going to divide the 216 microcoulomb on the value of the capacitor 3. So 216 divided on 24, that will give me 9 volt. Okay, and capacitor 4 will have the rest of the 36 volt, but it's not going to hurt if we check that. So we're going to divide 216 microcoulomb on the 18 microfarad, and it is giving me 27 volt. If you add 9 plus 27, that will give you back the voltage across the equivalent of them, which is the 36 volt. This is the way to solve this example. You don't need always to shrink or simplify the full circuit. You have to use the advantage of your knowledge that if they are parallel with the battery, I know their voltage straight away. In the case of C1 and C2, then I will find or simplify a certain branch or a certain part of the circuit, then I will reverse it quickly. I hope you find this video useful, and I'll see you again with another one. Thank you.